Hey folks, this is BestInSlot and welcome to today's coverage of the brand new Feathered Species Pack for Jurassic World Evolution 2. This releases tomorrow for all you lovely folks at home, along with the very big and chunky Update 6, and I'll be bringing you content on that a little bit later on today. But we're going to kick off today's coverage with my possible favourite of the bunch based on the screenshots and stuff pre-release, and that is the Yutyrannus, our big feathered tyrannosauroid. So before we release it, let's check out its stats. So releases in synthesis batch size 2 to 5, 5 at once is pretty sweet. Incubation cost 1 million, fairly expensive it must be said. Appeal is 645. You've got your dinosaur needs there. It likes scavengers like the Compsognathus, which is that a new thing? I don't remember that. And dislikes other carnivores and, of course, the Therizinosaurus, because they all do, because we're all terrified of it. The interesting thing is its base dominance is 97. 97 is actually quite low. If we look at similar medium carnivores like the Carnotaurus, 120, Baryonyx, 107, Ceratosaurus, 110, you know, all of these are above the Yutyrannus. So what it lacks in dominance, it makes up for in floofiness. And let's go check out that floofiness right now. Here we go with our Yutyrannus pack.
The Yutyrannus. The feathered tyrant brought so much excitement, so much intrigue to the scientific community when it was first discovered. And here we find ourselves in the presence of that illustrious tyrannosaur. Just don't be too surprised if it ruffles a few feathers, okay?
Doer. So, your ears do not deceive you. Unless my ears are deceiving me. But that was custom exit music for the Yutyrannus, and I believe, having recorded a couple of the other species, every species in the Feathered Species pack has unique exit music, which I think is like the first time they've done that since, say, like the Indoraptor or the Scorpius may have done, but there's a couple that do, but it feels like every single dinosaur in this pack, every species in this pack also has it. So that's really cool. The exit animation was fantastic, very bird-like, which I think is going to be a lot of the inspiration, of course, for the Yutyrannus, the way that they kind of slunk out. Wait, shut up. Social animation. So a little bird-like, which I can see being a common inspiration, kind of jutting its head side to side, and then as soon as it sees things are clear, it's got this aggressive charge out of the gates. Really cool. Social animation, nice little one, you know, walks up to it, bumps it on the booty a little bit, and then moves on with its life. Now let's pick one to have a look at when we're going to talk about the dinosaur design. Are you stripey? I need a stripey one. You're not stripey. Who among you has stripes? You have stripes. Let's have a look at our Yutyrannus then. So, our big, beautiful feathered tyrannosaurid. You can see the feathering ends there at the feet and just above the hands. It splays out a little bit on the sort of the wing sort of section. There's a little bit of jutting out there on the elbows. We've got this lovely counter shading going on with the sort of lighter, paler underbelly. And of course, the striping, which is part of the pattern. And again, I've said this on one of the other videos, but I really like that you can still make out the shape of the jaw and of the skull through the feathering. And that we've got a little bit of hanging skin there, hanging flesh and muscle and fat below the jaw as well. It just makes it feel more real as a creature. Whilst we're still on the head, I absolutely adore this patterning, the shaping they've done with that gradient descending colour. Just blends in really nicely with the feathering. The transition from feathers to scales is so nicely done. Lots of interesting little details and shapes and colorations there. And then of course we've got this large keratinous spike jutting out above the eyes, kind of horn-esque features popping up above the eyes. And the eyes themselves, I've got to say, they've brought their A-game with this pack. The texturing on the eyes is really, really nice. Again, I don't know if something's changed in this regard, but the eyes look phenomenal. They look almost haunting and cold and distant with the Yutyrannus, and I think it suits it really, really well. So a nice burst of colour there. That, of course, will probably be part of the pattern. And then at the back, obviously, we have the tail fan as well, with its frosted tips, like it's in an early 2000 boy band. And that sort of scales out to the side. Big, fluffy feather duster off a tail. But I love, again, that you can see the tail itself underneath that. And the feathers are kind of sitting on top of that and splaying outwards. So underneath, you can see it all, but from the top, you just see the splaying feathers. Overall, a gorgeous dinosaur. Really, really is. And if I hadn't already fallen in love with Dinocyrus today, then this would be fighting for my favorite. I think it might still be. I don't know. Design-wise, it's exceptional. I think it's absolutely beautiful. I think we maybe didn't look out in terms of skins, but of course I'll show you all the skins for the Yutyrannus later on in the species viewer when we get there. Even without the pattern though, I think it looks really good. So, anyways, let's check out some animations. Okay, our lovely snowy Yutyrannus has appeared at the meat feeder. Got company. Are we going to see the joint animation play out? Not quite yet. They're all approaching individually, so I can't showcase the joint animation. Slightly annoyingly. We'll get it at some point, but there you go. A fairly regular feeding animation. Nothing too much to say about that. Again, the head movements and stuff are all very reminiscent of avians to me personally. There's your drinking animation. I love just, there's just little subtle movements there at the end when she lifts her head up at the end. There's like this ripple in the muscle and skin under her neck and the entire body. I'll show you that again so you see what I mean. Occasionally pausing just there, just that little, it feels like you can just see the fat and muscle move realistically. It's fantastic. She sits. Little curling of the tail there. She also sits. There is like a sitting idle animation, so I'm just trying to see if I can spot that. I think that might be it. Just a little roar and the flapping of the tail, basically. That was rather unfortunate timing on the reload, but I think we got the key point there of the joint feeder animation, which was them both lifting up the same piece of meat in a slight Lady of the Tramp inspired moment, and the one on the left easily wins that battle. But the one on the right was kind of chill about it. It was just like, yeah, all right. Well, there's a lot more meat anyway, you know? It is what it is. But cool to get a little glimpse of that. Those joint feeder animations are something I didn't really appreciate enough when the game first came out, but again, they're a really nice dose of personality. I love seeing them. But with that done, we've seen the release, we've seen the stats, we've seen the social, we've seen the drinking, we've seen some idols, we've seen the regular food. I said, note these down on my list. Next up is the goat kill. It's time for something to die. Basically, I've gone too long now. It's time for something to be murdered. And here we go, folks. I'm going to play this first one at normal speed and we'll slow things down for the next one. All right, calm down, Yutyrannus. Okay, calm down there, buddy. That was, after the first two swings, I thought, okay, that's fairly normal. We've seen something like that before. Oh, we've got a sleeping animation over here. Seen something like that before, you know, nothing particularly unique. And then it just swings it and swings it and swings it and just never stops. It definitely had a playing with your food kind of vibe to it, which I think really suits the bird-like nature of the Yutyrannus in terms of some of its animations. And yet it sleeps like this and it's adorable and just seems so wholesome and sweet. Until you see it get a goat in its mouth. Right then, let's see that again in slow motion. I'm a little surprised it does it in one, because I mean, that's a tight fit to say the least. I'm proud of you though, buddy. Well done. Yeah, so a fairly chill goat eating animation. It's cool. It's nothing exceptional, I wouldn't say, in that regard, but it's pretty cool. I do like that slight playing nature of it. I think that's pretty fun. Right, homolocephaly is often the same style of kill, but let's check it out just in case. So I believe that is the standing up idle animation for the Yutyrannus there, where it stops and sniffs the ground and lets out a sort of warning call or an alert call to its fellow Yutyrannuses. Yutyrannopodes. Don't judge me for that. Well, not on purpose, you get to see a little bit of Yutyrannus combat. See how they attack. fairly normal stuff. Just vying for dominance, you know, vying for alpha, but just fairly standard bites and stuff like that. We'll see a little bit more dino and dino combat with Yutyrannus very shortly. Just thought I'd point that out whilst it's going on. I was hoping they'd come and kill the homolocephaly, but they seem much more interested in beating each other up than anything else. There we go. So, let's hop into slow-mo and see what happens here. Oh lord, he's coming. Usually the same as the goat, but you never know. Grabs hold. Oof! Oh, it's not the same as the goat. Oof! It's not the same as the goat at all. It doesn't even eat it. It's just, yeah, okay. We're done now. let's get rid of that. I'm going to do that again in... I need to get in the habit of doing it both in slow motion and in speedy motion, I suppose. This thing's a killing machine. It's got something so cold and sociopathic about it. You know, everything's brutal, much not in a way I expected, it must be said. But both kills so far, I've had this slightly... In that one, less so. That was less toying and more just die, die, and then I'm done with you. All right, let's check out a few of the others. It's worth pointing out, Yutyrannus is not a huge dinosaur. If we look at it in comparison to the Gallimimus here, it's not that much. It's longer, but it's shorter, you would say. Got a little closer at the end, but that's a pretty cool little initial move there where it nudges it to the ground almost. It like shoves it down with its head before it moves it out of the way. Let's check that one out again in slow-mo. I'm going to shoot this one in normal speed again, but I'm going to stick on the Gallimimus instead of my camera jutting all over the place. Oh, you missed there, buddy. Try again. I believe in you. There you go. You got this. You got this, pal. You got this. You got this. Again, yeah, not really any playing around with that one, is there? That's just knock it to the ground, bosh it to the ground with your body weight, and then rip its neck. Good boshing, my friend. Good boshing. Right, so let's check out a couple other animations. I'm going to release a Strachosaurus next. I'm assuming this is going to be fairly regular fighting, killing kind of thing, but I'm just going to check out the Stracho and the Wahoo-Wahoo-Wahoo-Saurus, and then we're going to check out a large carnivore. Yeah, pretty typical kill stuff. Nothing really to write home about in that regard. Now, let's test out some of the big boys. Oh. In the interest of ensuring I didn't miss anything... Yeah. Oh, little bite there. Not a push, but a little bite. Just wanted to throw in the... I know that was very quick that just happened. I wanted to make sure that I did get that medium carnivore kill, so I've recorded this afterwards. I do love one little detail in its animation, is how it always tilts its head to the side when it eats. You saw that first bite there. It's just tilted and dragging up like that. There you go. Nothing special in the kill, unfortunately, but... cool dinosaur all the same. I suspect Yutyrannus will not anytime... I was going to put it up against the Agrocamphosaurus next, and suddenly that seems like a very stupid idea, because I don't think it stands a chance. There is one more thing we need to check out, though. These carnivores often have a unique kill when it comes to the iguanodontids and hadrosaurids and stuff like that. So let's give that a go before we move on. Again, just to emphasize, Monosaurus is a big dinosaur, but oh boy, it's much, much bigger than Yutyrannus, to say the least. How is Yutyrannus going to possibly... I think that's the standard animation for that, where they run alongside it and they clamp down and they bite it and they just sort of drag it down to the ground. I'll pop out one more so we can see it one more time. Yeah, it's just reach around, bite on the neck, drag it down. I do love how the Edmontosaurus puts its forelimbs out onto the ground, kind of splays them out to try and stop itself as it's getting dragged around. But yeah, that's the animation we've seen before. So, nothing too much to talk about when it comes to the animations. I've got to say, I'm a little... I don't want to say I'm disappointed. In terms of the animations, though, that I've seen so far, then it's worth noting there may be specific combinations, there may be unique ones out there that I haven't seen. I can't test every interaction. If I see them, I'll bring them to you tomorrow on the channel. Of course I will, but for now, this is all I've seen, and I haven't seen anything. They're fine. You're going to see Dinocaris in the next video, and Dinocaris has some exceptional animations, one in particular. This hasn't hit that same spot for me quite yet. However, ladies and gentlemen, there is always hope, because there's still humans to kill, of course. Delicious, nutritious humans, and human kills are often the savior. So let me just turn a few things on here. Okay, I think we're in. Right, let's do this in normal speed first. Loves that shake, doesn't it? Okay, we're about to see it again. Over here. I do like that. Loves to toss things to the ground. It's absolutely obsessed. See if we get that in a slow motion this time around. God, I love the slow motion camera. Makes me so happy. So I love that as it comes around the corner, as it comes around the bend, as it's trying to grab onto the, it's got so much momentum behind it. It can't even keep itself on its feet. It slides down onto the ground. You can see the feet kicking out as it tries to right itself there. And then it calms down, rights itself up. And then a little bit of a shake to make sure they're dead. And then a toss to the side. I'm not actually interested in eating them. We're just here to murder them. Which really suits its seeming turn for the Yutyrannus, is just a murder machine. All its kills have been very, I don't know, what's the term? Utilitarian or very efficient? It's just, oh, hello. That was cheeky. I do like that, though. I like that it's so determined and so eager to enact this murder that it falls to the ground like its own momentum is too strong and it carries itself onto the floor. That says quite a lot about the Yutyrannus, to say the least. Come on, buddy. You're going to hook me up here. Always in the bloody shadow, I tell you. You see that left leg in particular as it slides to the ground? It's the one sort of trying to stick into the floor, into the earth to try to halt the skid, essentially. And then just tosses them so hard to the side. I do like that there's consistent behaviors with the Yutyrannus. There's a lot of shaking and there's a lot of tossing to the ground. You know, those have happened repeatedly. And when the same behaviors are roughly enacted the same way, it makes it feel like it's a real dinosaur because it's doing things, you know, that's like a behavior the Yutyrannus likes to do. So it makes sense that it would do it multiple times rather than changing up every single time, you know? I love that this woman is getting brutally murdered. Zipliners having a time just looking up and going, wait a minute. I don't think I'm getting off this zipline anymore. I'm going to show you the skins in a second. I'm going to hop over to the species viewer. I'm a little disappointed in the animation suite. And maybe I've been spoiled by the Dinocaris. Absolutely come back in half an hour for what may be my favorite animation in the entire game now. But these all felt... It's hard to rag on it too much, because it's a beautiful-looking dinosaur. The textures, the colours, you know, the design is phenomenal. And the way it's animated is beautiful, you know, in general. And the animation is really well-made, and there's a couple of them that I do enjoy. I just feel like it's maybe a little uninspired to an extent. It doesn't, none of them feel particularly unique or special, which I think is a shame for such a unique and special dinosaur. I will concede, however, it must be very difficult after making so many theropods, so many large carnivores, so many medium carnivores, to still come up with unique ways to animate them. Because at the end of the day, it's not going to use its arms or anything, but maybe it could use its tail somehow, would be fun. Maybe it could have... I don't know. I'd have to sit and properly think about it, but I would have liked to see a little bit more variety in the animation suite at the very least. But at the very least, it's very pretty. Let's hop and check it in the species viewer. What a beaut she is. So let's check out these animations. This is our standing idle animation. I did spot it a few times. I'm not sure I ever caught it. There's not much. Just kind of little shimmy to the side, basically a little look around. She walks. She runs. God, look at the tail movement. How beautiful is that tail fan? Absolutely stunning. She sits and she idle sits. Oh, like a little You see there, just watch the throat movement when that happens. It's really nice. But you can see the shake, the vibrate. This is what I mean, the little animations, the lifelike animations that bring the dinosaur to life is really good. It's just the kills I'm a little disappointed in. But hey, maybe I missed like a really cool one. Always a possibility. Oh, she's an absolute beauty though. Let's get her back up and check out the skins. So this is Yukon River. And let's go through all those first. Yukon River is the default, but we've got Sonoran Desert, Death Valley, Great Sandy Desert, Champlain Valley, Salar del Huesco, Limpopo River, Killian Mountains. These three are very similar. Killian Mountains, Yukon River, by far my favorite, I think. It just suits. It's when I see a Yutyrannus in my head, I see a white dinosaur with black markings. You know, it's perfect. It's Svalbard, pretty nice as well. Amazon Rainforest, Mangrove Forest, and the Gambia River Basin. I think this is quite an easy winner for me with the Yukon, but we'll see how it works with the colours. Rana, as I say, is the default with the black striping, the blue keratinous horn thing going on there, and a little dash of red on the eyes as well. And a little bit of red there in the tail, sort of yellow, creamy, beigey colours there. We've got Calcarana, which has this slightly lighter grey in the stripes, but changes the horn to a yellow colour instead. We've got Lithobates, which is red and red. We've got Pulcrana, which of course you can barely see, so let's swap that to something else. What do we want to use? Well, you've seen it now. I suppose it doesn't really matter, but it's got that bright pink keratin, which is pretty sweet. And then the white stripes. I said white stripes far too much in this video. Papyrana, which is pinkish, sort of on the striping, and the lovely sort of indigo-violet colours there on the horn. It looks really nice like that. This highlights more the colouring on the face than the other ones do. And same with that one. Again, those bright bursts of green and blue on the face, really highlighted on the darker skins, as you can see, more than on the light skins. But beautiful all the same. Yeah, really cool. I love the Yutyrannus so much. I feel like all I'm doing, I don't love a lot of these base colours. Again, I feel like they could have pushed the colour. It's a super, I don't know, I feel like the colour could have been pushed a little bit more in terms of the saturation and stuff like that. I think that would have been quite nice. I really like that one, actually. It's kind of like tiger striped, I suppose. It's pretty sweet. Even without patterns, though, they look pretty sweet. Actually, I might prefer that one without a pattern. Yeah, I like some of them. I think some of the, there's just too many sort of brownie ones for my liking, I guess. But generally speaking, it's a nice suite of skins. And this, I mean, I'm going to have them all look like that, and I'd be perfectly happy. I think that is a staggeringly beautiful dinosaur. And that is it. That is the Yutyrannus. So let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Come back in, I think, probably half an hour. Well, probably now quarter of an hour for the Dinochirus. And then, of course, we'll have the other two species and eventually a video on update 6 as well with all the juicy new details. I hate the word juicy, by the way. Just want to point this out there. Thank you so much for joining me. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. And I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.